Good afternoon. I'm Frank Steed, Chairman of the Republican Party of Navarro County. A couple of years ago, shortly after I became chairman, I attended an executive committee meeting of the Ellis County Republican Party. Prior to that, I had not been active in Navarro County politics. I had begun attending meetings in 2004 and became an election judge in 2006, but I'd never thought of or had experience leading the local party. So I set out to meet with other county chairmen, observe how they ran their meetings, listen and learn. That night in Ennis, there were a couple of folks from Waco presenting a program about Hispanic inclusion. Now, community activist has become a dirty word since 2008, but these two folks were informed, engaged, and had a message that got my attention. Duke Machado and Janet Jackson spoke about the changing face of the Texas population. They had facts and figures and convinced me rapidly that Hispanic vote, which has traditionally been for the Democratic candidate in any race, would soon be the vote that made the election decision. They also spoke to the values of the Hispanic culture and how these were much more in line with the Republican platform of value than those of the party that received their vote almost automatically. The reaction from the audience that evening was interesting. As in Navarro County, there was a mix of conservative and moderate Republicans. Many thought the message was worth the time and support, while others wanted to focus on illegal immigrants and border protection. Duke and Janet were professional and unwavering in answering all the questions. They continued to bring the message back to the point that the Republican Party at the national, state, and county level had better figure out how to listen and respond to these growing demographic changes, or we would be losing races in landslide numbers in the next decade. I was impressed and wanted to learn more. I understood the need, but was unsure about what to do. I collected the contact information from Duke and Janet. They had started calling the group GOP Is For Me, but did not yet have the slick marketing pieces that you'll see them with today. What they did have was a message that I didn't think could be ignored, and a passion to deliver that message to any group that would listen. Within a couple of months, we had Janet and Duke present to our monthly meeting, and they received a warm but reserved response. Folks embraced the idea, they saw the need, but didn't know how to reach out to this growing but very quiet community in Corsicana and Navarro County. We committed to stay in touch and look for ways to address these issues in our local community. From my past business experience, I knew we needed a champion, someone to own the message and help us deliver it to our constituents. Over the next few months, through the Corsicana and Navarro County Chamber of Commerce and its work with downtown business owners, I met Raul and Monica Jimenez. They were active, passionate, and very conservative. Not long afterwards, I met Ralph Gonzalez, who had recently become active in the community and announced his candidacy for mayor of Corsicana. While the campaign was not successful, it did bring Ralph and Raul together and gave us the idea for finding that traction that was missing for a Hispanic initiative in Navarro County. With their passion and direction from Duke, we felt we had the catalyst for success. GOP Is For Me has continued to grow. There is now a great website, a radio presence, and they have played a large role in the election of Bill Flores to the U.S. Congress. In addition, more and more counties were hearing the message and starting their own Hispanic clubs. Janet had become the SREC committee woman for SD 22, and with her efforts, the group was now an official affiliate of the Republican Party of Texas. Danny Combs and the Navarro County Conservatives have taken up the cause and encouraged meetings of these two groups. And thank you, Danny, this would not be happening for you. He introduced Ralph and Raul to Duke and Janet, the message clicked, and the relationship blossomed. In the months since those early meetings, Duke and Janet made trip after trip from Waco and Clifton to meet Ralph, Raul, Monica, Donnie, Margarita, Gloria, and a growing number of Navarro County Hispanics. The Hispanic Republican Club of Navarro County has been formed and welcomed as an affiliate club of the Republican Party of Navarro County. They meet monthly and their ranks are swelling. They have held seminars, working sessions, and registered many voters who had little interest in participating before. We have new precinct chairmen, and for the first time in the 2012 primary, we will have Republican election judges in precincts 200 and 201. These folks have worked countless hours, traveled hundreds of miles, and spent hour upon hour bringing us to today. It's still a small movement. We measure our success in baby steps, not giant leaps. But the message I first heard and addressed 3 years ago is now being repeated over and over right here in our county. The Navarro County Hispanic Republican Club will deliver the message and grow our Hispanic base to keep pace with these changing times and changing demographics. We would not be here today without the tireless efforts of Janet, Hugh, Ralph, and Raul, and their entire team. Before you hear from our candidates, I would like you to hear the message that got my attention that evening in Ennis. I'm thrilled we have so many of our candidates with us today to hear that message so that it can be embraced by their campaigns and their constituents. Together, we will accomplish the number one goal of the Republican Party of Navarro County. This fall, we will hold every elected seat in the Navarro County Courthouse. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to introduce to you the founder of GOP is for me, Mr. Duke Machado.